I show you how to unify feature structures with each other. But before I do that, I have to give you some information about the symbols. If you have something like this as a feature structure S1, strange symbol, feature structure S, and this symbol looks somehow similar to the subset symbol. Let's say you have the sets M1, which is a subset of M. You may or may not know this symbol from mathematics lessons. And this means that if you have two sets, then all elements from this set are also in this set. And for feature structures, it means something similar. It means that all properties from S1 are also in S. And if you can unify, that's the symbol for unify, if you can unify S1 with S2, and what you get is a feature structure S, that means that S2 is also, I don't know, I did not find how it's called, but it's something like maybe a sub-feature structure or a feature structure that contains a part of the properties, a subset of the properties of S. Well, that's the case. If you unify two feature structures and you get another one, that means both of them must be, sub-feature structures of S, or that S must contain all properties of both of those feature structures. Now let's erase all those stuff, because I need it for drawing. Now let's unify T1 with T2. I will unify T1 with T2, and what comes out is what I'm drawing now. And because the unification must contain all properties of both of the two feature structures, I can start by writing down all properties from 2, 1. So it's last name and first name, don't count me on the spelling or the writing, it's just the same as what it's there. Then you have some address called private, which contains street, main street, and town Springfield. Oh, I just shortened this. And then we have to add all the properties from T2. And there we have another property, private. Well, another thing to mention, that T2 also contains last name and first name, but they don't have a value, so they are not written down. And that means in unification we can just take the properties from T1. So we can just take last name and first name from T1, because in T2 they are underspecified. Now we have here the property private, and here we had the property private, so it's already there. And here it says it must have a sub-property, a property town. We already have a town here. And here is nothing specified, but there's a pointer that points to this field. And that means in both of those two fields must be the same. So I will just add the pointer now from T2, or you know what, I will do this stuff from T2 in a different color. So here we have the pointer, which comes from T2, so I will just take the pointer with me. And here the pointer points to Springfield, and the entries must have the same value. And as you can see here, or maybe you see it here, we already have the value Springfield from 2-1. So we don't have a problem here. The fields, they contain the same value and they can be unified with each other. So you can unify two properties, two atomic properties, either if one is not specified or if both are the same. And you unify complex properties by unifying all properties that are inside of them. Now in T2 we have another property called office, and I need a longer bracket for that. We have a property office, which we don't have yet. The office has a street and a town. Town has a pointer. Then we have here the town is Springfield and the street is High Street. And now we have a feature structure with all features that are either in T1 or in T2. So that means we are done, and I will show you the other unifications in other videos.